Hello and welcome back to our LEGO Star Wars The Complete Saga walkthrough. In this part, we're going to begin the first level. The only reason I'm doing this part, like, 5 seconds after I stopped the previous part was because I want to save my progress, so I'm just going to do this. The first level is called Negotiations. There's two modes, Story and Free Play, which you can't see because it's on the touch screen. Story is you basically follow the story of Star Wars. You get two to seven characters in your level, depending on which level it is, and then you play with those characters and you don't get to pick your own. It gives you the same every time. But in free play, which you unlock after completing the story mode for that mission, you complete. You can choose any characters you want. Well, you pick the first character at least, and the rest are randomized. But at least they're randomized. You get a variety of characters. Like, you wouldn't have a stormtrooper in the prequels normally, but in free play you can. So let's begin. Press start to skip the intro. My nice blue 3DS. It used to be a red 3DS, but it broke. We bought this one back in Black Friday. Lego pieces. So, here we are in the droid control ship. Start out. Start out by getting our first Lego studs of the main game. Oh, see that meter up there? That is True Jedi. If you get a certain amount of studs in the levels, you get the gold brick, you get True Jedi, and then if at the end of the level, if you have received True Jedi status, you get the gold brick award, which you can get, I believe, two per mode per level. So I think there are three in story, there are five total per level, basically. The green glow, that's the force glow. That signals that you can use the force on that object. Like I said in the previous part. Try to get every stud in the level. Or almost every stud. And the hearts, they restore your four health. And if you lose all four hearts, you lose some studs, and you regenerate, and you lose some studs. So you gotta be careful of that. Get my lightsaber ready. This next area, they're gonna be your first enemies, and they're the battle droids. I'm gonna go ahead and destroy the battle droids before I get you. Please don't mind me singing along, because I am like a lot of people like to sing along to the Star Wars music. Hum along to the Star Wars music. And approach piles and Lego and hold the A button to build. So this one is a protocol droid. This is a protocol droid, and I believe in the next room world we'll unlock new characters to add to your party. That'll happen sometimes in levels where you get new characters to add to your party. In this case, I won't tell you yet. if you've seen the movie, you know. Who comes along. Well, they don't really come along. It's kind of out of order, but... And I got my first mini kit from destroying, now we're in the next area where there are more battle droids. And I know there are more coming up. There's a friendly character over there. Well, there are special Jedi moves where if you jump and Y, it'll do a Jedi lunge. If you do a double jump and Y, it'll do a Jedi slam. Jedi Slams are the, we'll get to that in the third area. I used a touch screen on that one, which I'm not going to do that anymore because it's hard without a stylus. Sorry, Obi-Wan. So this room... can only be opened by a bounty hunter like Boba Fett. And there are fruit boxes that give you, if you get all three in the level, you get the last Lego canister of the level. Out of GC-14, she's now in our party. She's a female protocol droid. Fix my camera alignment. I'm gonna use this mini kit and then I'm gonna backtrack to that protocol door we saw before. That's two mini kits and then it'll be three in a second here because we're gonna backtrack. Ooh, this is a touchscreen game. I'm gonna have to... There we go. We open that door. Unlock the door. Now here's the secret room. So that mini kit floating in midair. We have to unlock that platform first. These you really want to get. The blue studs are worth 1,000. I should have mentioned that in the first part. Silver are worth 10, gold are worth 100, and blue are worth 1,000. Now in the console editions, there's also purple studs, which are worth 10,000, but that's only in the Wii edition and Xbox 360 and PS3 and PC. So non-handheld editions. And we get another mini kit. Go through this door, which doesn't... This one is unlocked. You just need a protocol door to a droid to fully unlock it. Like that. There's no mini game required. Get ready. I'm just making sure something wasn't wrong with the game because it was, because it wasn't making me lose health like it's supposed to. Watch out for what comes next. There are a bunch of droidicas. See? The only way to destroy droidicas is to either... Jedi slam them, which I find more effective, or deflect blaster bolts at them. In the console edition, whenever you Jedi slam them, their shield turns red. That's one. The next room has been unlocked. Got a heart to refill. No, there's unlimited droids in this area, so we have to stay on one side of the... They just keep mysteriously. I'm pretty sure it's a bug that the game has. Store those before they notice me. There they are. That kind of scared me a little. Now here we have some more studs. Let's go in this door before those droids get us. But there are even more down here, so you have to be prepared for more fighting as soon as you get down here, because there are lots more down here in the control base. And this is the first part where they come down using their grappling hooks. That's it? Wow. I think there's one more over here, though. Those lamps, you have to have a Sith to light. Those lamps, you have to have a Sith to light. It's quicker to use your, especially if there are droids in the area, then it's easier to use your stylus, or finger, or whatever you use. You have to have R2-D2 or another astro droid to get up there, and sadly we don't have one until level 4, I believe, which will be the 5th part. Almost a true Jedi. I remember my first walkthrough on this game from years ago, like a couple years ago. I did before I had a YouTube channel. I was just gonna burn it to DVD and share it with friends. That was my original plan. That was a couple years ago, though. And that had some... Well, then... Ooh, I keep messing up with the camera angle. That only makes any use if you want to get back up on the... Here's a lever that I can build that, when activated, it will activate, like, a platform. And that will build a grappling hook platform, which only blaster characters can use. Ooh, I just got True Jedi. There's a mini kit up there that I can't get. Some mini kits you have to get in free play. I'm trying to get as many studs as possible. I know you can get lots. Let's move on. Or there are even more droids. There's a couple droidicas as well. I believe I should take care of the droidicas first. What do you think? Yeah, I'll take care of them first. Too many of them. They just keep coming. I think that was the last one. I think it's the power bricks up here. Got the red power brick. Those don't make a ting noise when you, like a Lego noise when you, This thing is a travel chute, which only small characters, for example, young Anakin or Yoda, can use travel chutes. Only small characters, basically. Seems just like yesterday, like... 2.5 years ago, I started playing this game. That's when I first started playing video games at all. This is when I first started playing that's when I first started playing console video games at all. Well, I played computer games, regular computer video games, PC games before that. Like, little kid PC games, like, when I was really young. If final room of the level. Roger, roger. Roger, roger. There are also lots of droids in this area that just keep coming. Nice deflection. Oh, if when a blaster bolt's really close to you, you can easily deflect it. Okay, I guess that was a commander droid. They have more health than normal droids do. There are lots of studs in this area. Another grapple pad. Only Astro droids can activate this panel. We got two of the three fruit boxes. So I only get, I don't get a mini kit for that. Now I'm almost done with the level. To finish the level, you simply have to enter that, but you have to force this. Another door will open. And now, to end the level. Unlock the rest of the episodes by completing the first level. Unlock PC-14 as a secondary character to use in free play. I probably could have gotten another mini kit. Unlock the power brick one. Quit to the cantina. Get him done with the pit for today. I will be starting my Super Mario 3D Land walkthrough today as well. I'll replace game one. Thank you for watching this part of LEGO Star Wars The Complete Saga, and goodbye.